Here are 5 ways psychologists are confronting the opioid crisis. Each day, in the United States, 130 people die from an opioid overdose. But opioid use disorder is treatable, and psychologists are playing a key role. Number 1, enhancing treatment with behavioral interventions. While medication like methadone, buprenorphine, and naltrexone is the backbone of treatment, it is just one component. Psychologists are working on treatment teams to address conditions that often go hand in hand with opioid use disorder, like anxiety, depression, post-traumatic stress disorder, and chronic pain, all of which can lead to relapse. Number 2, expanding social supports. Successful treatment takes a comprehensive approach. That's why psychologists are designing programs that support people with housing, work, and relationship challenges. Family therapy interventions are helping people repair relationships fractured by drug use, which can support a loved one's recovery. Number 3, addressing stereotypes. The stigma surrounding substance abuse can fuel unfair treatment and deter a person from seeking help. In response, psychologists are working to uproot stigma by educating people about substance use, including changing the language used to describe it. For example, using the term person living with addiction instead of addict puts the person, not the disease, first. Number 4, managing pain without substances. The most commonly used and best studied psychological treatment for pain is cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, which helps people with addiction think differently about their pain and resume activities that they fear might trigger pain. CBT helps prevent people in pain from using opioids and can help patients who are already taking them wean off. Number 5, identifying patients at risk. Psychological assessments help determine patients' readiness to receive and recover from potentially painful procedures. Recently, psychologists developed an app that allows people to rate their pain intensity, mood, and other factors, alerting psychologists or other providers who can intervene to help. To learn more, click the link in the top right to read our special report on opioids in the APA Monitor. And before you go, please give us a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching, and make sure to check out these other videos from APA.